They're cute. They're sexy. They're even destructive. Teen Idols are back, 90s style. For young fans, they rule the world. But life can be pretty scary for these monsters of rock and roll, always in danger of being crushed by horny mall rats. Over the decades, teen idols have struck like a tornado, but ended up just blowing in the wind. Will our 90s faves suffer the same fate? They're talented, they're captivating, and they're oh so ingenious.
We're like kids in some ways, like we like to have a go at everything.
They're the teen idols of the 90s, and you better start dealing with them. Was what teen idols looked like when we were growing up. Today, it's a different story. If you take a good look at the CD covers your kids are listening to, you'll see that today's teen idols look a little different. They certainly dress better, in my opinion. If you're not exactly sure who it is your kids are listening to, climb out from under your Partridge Family albums and we'll tell you. Unlike the Partridge Family, you probably won't see a lot of moms in today's teen idol bands. Sorry, Shirley. But brothers? Well, that's another story. Began way back in 1997. Up until then, it was a decade filled with more bitter grunge than sweet pop. Can you say Hanson? The music world can't ignore these three young boys brimming with adolescence and silly string.
Finally, somebody made music that will make you feel up and happy.
Okay, everybody, you ready for Hanson?
Ike wrote his first song when he was in third grade, and then Zach and I started about a year or two later writing songs, so I was probably about seven. We've been singing as a group for about 6 years.
Even with 6 years of, well, experience under their pull-ups, the music industry still had to be sold. These tiny tykes from Tulsa were turned down by 14 record companies before they finally signed with their current label, Mercury.
You think, well, how could anybody have turned this down? But I think people were really scared because, in general, historically, teen idols have had an air of cheesiness about them. And I think a lot of people were worried about credibility issues and being taken seriously if they recorded and put out records by teen idols.
If you think about it,
teenagers are the ones
who buy
music.
Who buys records? I mean, really, really any band, when it comes down to the mass, like, buying power, it's teenagers, it's, you know, 25 and under, who's the people that really go out and buy a ton of records.
Hanson certainly knows what keeps their fridge stocked with juice boxes.
You're at a Hanson concert, there's no rules. What? The only rule is, you cannot stand still. You have to have fun. You have to go crazy. And you can't be here if you're not having fun. So let's go. Here we go, come on!
I think to a certain degree, they may identify with you as far as just the age.
I think you hope they will go with you. And you hope that you can expand and add new things to music.
You hope that you'll still be around where they can grow.
Yeah, I mean, you hope you'll still be around where people can go with you.
I will come to you.
We're doing it because we've always done it and because music is what we do. So this is what they're getting. They're getting the real thing.
Not since the Osmonds and the Jackson 5 have a group of brothers hit so big. They've already gone multi-platinum with their first album. They've been on countless magazine covers, had their own television special, and even have had a couple of best-selling biographies written about them. All this before they can even sip a beer. The teenage market is certainly important to these guys. In fact, teenagers have always been important to the music business. So why the bad rap on teen idols? A lot of people feel that if you're a teen idol, you're probably all hype and no substance. Well, in a lot of cases, that may be true. But there have been bands that started off as teen idols and went on to rule the world. Remember Elvis?
The
The 50s was more than just the beginning of rock and roll. It was the beginning of